نستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Dear brothers and sisters, inshallah, the reminder today is about the end of Surah Hud, the verses from the end of Surah Hud, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ فَاخْتُلِفَ فِيهِ. We surely have given Musa, Moses alayhi salatu wasalam, the book, and they differed about it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout the Quran tells us about the people of the book that this is what they have done. They always differed after the book has come, the book which is supposed to unite them. The book that is supposed to show them the truth and the guidance so they will follow it, but then they differ after it has come. ولولا كلمة سبقت من ربك لقضي بينهم وإنهم لفي شك منه مريب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all able. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all able. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He can wipe out those who disbelieve and right away give victory to the believers. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose not to do that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah informs us that about them, that they were completely in doubt regarding what they have been given. وَإِنَّ كُلَّا لَمَّا لَيُوَفِّيَنَّهُمْ رَبُّكَ أَعْمَالَهُمْ إِنَّهُ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. Allah will reward all of them for the deeds that they have chosen to do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all aware. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the believers that they should remain steadfast. فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ وَمَنْ تَابَ مَعَكَ وَلَا تَطْغَوْا إِنَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the believers to remain firm upon the truth. They should not lean towards supporting the wrongdoers. وَلَا تَرْكَنُوا إِلَى الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا فَتَمَسَّكُمُ النَّارِ وَمَا لَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مِنْ أَوْلِيَاءَ ثُمَّ لَا تُنْصَرُونَ. Do not be on the side of the wrongdoers. You will have no supporter supporting you against Allah's punishment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the believers to establish the prayers. أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ طَرَفَيِ النَّهَارِ وَزُلَفَ مِنَ اللَّيْلِ. Establish the prayers towards the two ends of the day and part of the night. إِنَّ الْحَسَنَاتِ يُذْهِبْنَ السَّيِّئَاتِ ذَلِكَ ذِكْرَى لِلذَّاكِرِينَ. Surely the good deeds, they wipe away the bad ones. That is a reminder for those who take heed. That is a reminder for those who remember. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the believers to be patient. وَاصْبِرْ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. The reward of the doers of good is never lost with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions to us what the people of the past have done, the evil people, the nations that were before us, what they have done. Had there were amongst them a group of them who command good and forbid evil, that's what is supposed to have happened. فَلَوْلَا كَانَ مِنَ الْقُرُونِ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ أولو بقية ينهون عن الفساد في الأرض إلا قليلا ممن أنجينا منهم. Most of them did not care to do what is right and to stop the corruption. They didn't bother, except for a few. We need to be from those few who stop the evil around us, stop the corruption around us, and not accept it, not okay it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاتَّبَعَ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مَا أُتْرِفُوا فِيهِ وَكَانُوا مُجْرِمِينَ. What rather they have done, instead of stopping the evil, stopping the corruption, they just followed what they wanted to do, those who are mutrafin, those who are just living their lavish, extravagant life. They just chose to go on with that, and they were amongst those who were criminals. Allah says, وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ لِيُهْلِكَ الْقُرَى بِظُلْمٍ وَأَهْلُهَا مُصْلِحُونَ. مُصْلِحُونَ يعني صالحون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wouldn't have destroyed cities just by being unjust towards them. Allah wouldn't do that. He wouldn't destroy them while they are righteous and calling to righteousness and commanding good and forbidding evil. Allah wouldn't destroy them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ لَجَعَلَ النَّاسَ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً. Had your Lord wished, He would have made the people just one nation. Just one nation upon belief. All of them are believers. No disbelievers. If Allah wished, He could have done that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all able. He created the creations, and He is in full control of everything within them, including their hearts, their choices, and their wills. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the free will to choose the righteous, the way of righteousness, or the way of misguidance. So Allah says, وَلَا يَزَالُونَ مُخْتَلِفِينَ. And they would continue to differ. They would continue to differ. There will be those who choose the wrong path, and they will exist. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destined that this is something that will happen. People will differ. They will choose the wrong path. They will not choose the truth. Allah says, إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ رَبُّكَ. Except for those whom Allah have given mercy, have shown mercy. Those, they will choose the truth over falsehood. These are the ones who are marhumin. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be amongst them, the people of rahmah, the people who truly deserve Allah's mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلِذَلِكَ خَلَقَهُمْ. It is for this that He created them. This whole life is a test. This whole life is an examination. Either to listen and to obey, سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا, you follow Allah's revelation that He has given to the messengers, or you choose to disobey, وَالْعَيَذُ بِاللَّهِ. You choose to disobey this way or this way. And based on this choice that you make in this life, then the reward at the next life or in the next life. Either you will be in paradise or someone will choose otherwise, and therefore he will end up in the fire. وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ وَلِذَلِكَ خَلَقَهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يعني, so that they will end up differing. Some of them choose right, some of them choose wrong. And then in the end, based on that, the reward will be in the next life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَتَمَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ أَجْمَعِينَ. The word of your Lord has been perfected, that He will fill Jahannam from the jinnies and from the humans all together. those who choose the wrong path from the jinn, those who choose the wrong path from the humans, they follow the way of the shaitan, that's where they will end. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will fill Jahannam of those people who disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and chose to go in the wrong path. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله رب العالمين أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما صليت على آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما باركت على آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us the stories of the people who were before us, the nations that were before us. Allah says, وَكَذَلِكَ وَكُلًّا نَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الرُّسُلِ مَا نُثَبِّتُ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ. Allah mentions to His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that He mentions to him the stories of the messengers that were before, and many of them were mentioned in the surah, and they are mentioned throughout the Quran in different ways. The story, the same one and the same story is being repeated in different ways. And Allah says this will lead to the heart becoming firm on the path of the truth. وَجَاءَكَ فِي هَذِهِ الْحَقِّ وَمَوْعِظَةٌ وَذِكْرَى لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And it has come to you in this, that is this surah, the truth and admonishment and a reminder for the believers. So when we recite the Quran, when we go through the verses of the Quran, this should bring us an admonition, a maw'idha. It gives us a lesson. And this admonition and lesson should make us remember. So this is what we have in the Quran. That's why we need to turn to the Quran and read over again. Allah says, وَقُلْ لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. And this is what we should say to them. Those who disbelieve, we should say to them this, what Allah is telling us to say to them. وَقُلْ لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Say to those who do not believe, اعملوا على مكانتكم إِنَّا عَامِلُونَ. Do whatever you are doing. Continue to work in the same, to labor in the same condition you are upon. Do your doings, and we do our doings. You do your acts, and we do our acts. وَانْتَظِرُوا إِنَّا مُنْتَظِرُونَ. Wait, for we are waiting too. There is no swift reward, final reward in this worldly life. The final reward will be in the next life. Some punishments do happen within this world, and believers, sometimes they get their right in this world, sometimes they don't get their rights in this world, and therefore they will get it in the next. So it's just a waiting period of time. It's a waiting game, and then we see who will win in the end. وَلِلَّهِ غَيْبُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَإِلَيْهِ يُرْجَعُ الْأَمْرُ كُلُّهُ فَاعْبُدْهُ وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَيْهِ وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. To Allah belongs all the ghaib, the hidden, unseen world. To Allah belongs that world, that whatever that happens within the heavens and the earth of the ghaib, the things that are unseen to us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is well aware of that. So whatever is going on, Allah knows it. Even if we don't know about it, we might know about some, we might have not known about so many things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the good things and the bad things, the justice and the injustice. Allah is well aware of all of that subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to Him returns all the affairs. So worship Him and do rely upon him, and your Lord is never unaware of what you do. These are the words from the Quran, Kalamullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, towards the end of Surah Hud. I wish that we take heed, we should benefit from the Quran, the verses of the Quran, as the Quran was sent down for us to read it and to reflect over it and to derive lessons from it in our daily lives. And if we do, we will be from those who are on the right path, and we will be from those who are steadfast and firm. We will not be shaken. We will not be wavering because of the many things that are happening around us. We are believers. We choose faith. We choose to follow the straight path. We don't mind. We don't care about those who are conspiring against us. Rather, we will not run away from them. We will face them. And we will call them and invite them to the truth with wisdom and beautiful preaching. For who knows? إِنَّ رَبَّكَ هُوَ أَعْلَمْ بِمَنْ ضَلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ وَهُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِالْمُهْتَدِينَ. Surely your Lord is well aware of those who have strayed away from his path and those who are guided and choose guidance. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit all of us from what we heard and to make us from a people who listen to a statement and follow the best of it. اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذ بك منه عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل ونسألك أن تجعل كل قضاء قضيته لنا خيرا. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وفرج كروبنا وكروب المسلمين. اللهم أنزل رحمة من رحمتك وشفاء من شفائك على أوجاعنا وكروبنا. اللهم ارحمنا رحمة تغنينا بها عن رحمة من سواك. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن له حق علينا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وأقم الصلاة.